Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's look at 10 uses for Mac Finder aliases. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, if you've never used aliases before in the Finder, they are ways to create links to files so you can access them in other places. On Windows, these are called shortcuts. You can create aliases one of four ways. You can select a file and then choose File and then Make Alias, and that makes an alias right there. If you look closely at the icon, you'll see that there's a little curved arrow there at the bottom left-hand corner of the icon letting you know that's an alias. You can change the name to whatever you want. It doesn't have to stay the same as the original file, but you can access it the same way that you do the original file. Double clicking on this file will open it up, but also double clicking on the alias will open it up as well. Another way to create an alias you may have noticed here is there's a keyboard shortcut, Control Command A. You could also control click on any file and then choose Make Alias there from the context menu. And in addition to that, when you drag a file, you can put it anywhere you want, like say in the desktop. If you hold Command Option, you'll see the curved arrow there, and when you drop it, it creates an alias instead of moving or copying the original file. So that's actually use number one for aliases. You can put an alias to a file on the desktop. So if you have everything arranged neatly in the Documents folder, like I do here, you don't want to move the file out of its folder, but you also want to have the convenience of accessing it from the desktop. You can drag and drop an alias to the desktop. And now even if I don't have a Finder window open or I'm not looking at that particular folder, I can access this file by double clicking on it. Now you could also use that to access the file in another folder. So for instance, say if you find every day you're working in this folder here, but you also need to access a special file that's somewhere else, like here. I could create a new alias for that file, and then I can move it into the other folder. And now when I'm in that folder, I have access to that file right there. I don't have to go and leave this folder to go find it in wherever it's located. Now you can also use aliases on folders, not just for files. So for instance, say here in my Project Alpha folder, I need to regularly access under Media my sample photos folder. Well, I can create an alias for that. This time I'm going to hold the Command and Option keys and drag. Going to go into my Work Projects folder, Project Alpha, and drop it in there. And now I have an alias to the Sample Photos folder. So I can access those files. Even here in Column View, I can see the list of files, and it looks like I'm still in my Project Alpha folder. It makes it really convenient. If you have several folders that you need to access while working on a certain project, you can create aliases to them so you have quick and easy access to them right in here. I can even add files to this folder right here through the alias and actually go into the folder even though it looks like I'm inside the Project Alpha folder here. Now you can use this to create collections of folders. So for instance, I'll create a new folder here and I'll call it Common Folders. And in there I could put a variety of different aliases. So let's put an alias to Nature Photos. I'll use Command and Option to drag that in there. I'll also put an alias to Project Alpha and one to TPS Reports here. Now I go into Common Folders and I see those three locations there like they're under Common Folders even though none of them are. It's just aliases to the actual folders. So one thing I can do with this is I could drag and drop this folder I created over to my favorites here. Now let's say I'm in an app and I create a new file and I go to save it. And let's say there are some common locations where I save files. Those happen to be those folders there. I can easily click here to Common Folders and select any one of these places to save the file. It will save it in that actual folder even though these three folders are at very different locations on my drive. So you can kind of use a folder full of aliases as a drop zone to save things. If I wanted to, I could have even put this Common Folders folder here on the desktop instead, and then I can go into it and have the set of drop zones where I can drop different files into it. And that's just spring loading. I can even take a file like this, move it to Common Folders, wait a second, it will open this up, and then I can drop it in to the folder I need. And I can do the same thing with files. So I can create a folder, I'll just call it Common Files. And I can put various different aliases in here using Command Option and then access all of these from that one folder instead of going into the actual locations where they are. So you can see I have those three in there. Now whether I have a folder full of files or a folder full of folders, I can add this to the right side of the dock here. I'll add both of these and now I've got all of that stuff here in the dock. I can access these files really easily from a stack in the dock, even though each of these files is in a separate location. Now you can also create aliases for apps. Now the dock is kind of a set of aliases for apps already. So you don't really need it with your most common apps. But let's say your dock is getting crowded. One of the things you can do is you can create a new folder, say in your documents folder, and call it other apps. And then I could go in a separate Finder window here to the Applications folder. And I could select apps here and drag and drop them holding Command and Option to create aliases to those apps. The apps are still here in the Applications folder, but now I've put aliases to them here. I could access them right from here, but I could also drag this folder to the right side of the dock. And I have this other apps stack here. And now I can launch other apps and you can see I've got four apps. You could have 40 if you wanted to and they would only take up one slot here in the dock. Another thing you can do with aliases, you can create aliases for files that are on external drives as well. So I have an external drive here and let's say I wanted to have an alias for easy access to this folder here. I could drag and drop it with Option and Command to the desktop. Now instead of having to go and look for that drive and then dig down to find that folder, I could simply go in and open it up directly by double clicking on that folder. The alias will stay there even if the drive isn't connected. So you can have a consistent place where this appears whether the drive is connected or not. But of course you'll only be able to access it if the drive is connected at that moment. Now you could do the same thing for network drives. So I'll click on network here and there's my MacBook Pro and I can go and select a folder here. And let's say I wanted to create an alias to the pictures folder on that other computer. I could do that. Now going to that alias will take me directly to that folder on that computer or a network drive. And now if I disconnect that computer, I'll see it disappear from there, but the alias stays there. It just no longer works, but the folder is still there. So I don't have to recreate it every time I connect. And when that network drive or computer is available again, I don't have to do anything special to reconnect to it. I can just go right into that folder and it will automatically reconnect me. Now one more cool thing about aliases is you can move them. You could see this clip art and media folder that links to an external drive there. I could take that. I could move that in here. I could move it somewhere else and it will always work. So I can keep moving it around or even duplicating it to make another copy of the alias and they both go to the same place. If you ever want to go and see where the original folder for an alias is, you can select it and go to File and then Show Original. And it will jump and you can see now I'm actually in Media Nature Photos. You could also use Command I or File Get Info and see information here. It'll tell you the original location right there. And you can even use a Select New Original button to reassign that alias to another folder or file. So I hope you found this look at using Finder aliases on your Mac useful. They really can come in handy if you have a lot of folders and subfolders and projects commonly reuse or access different files in different locations on your drive or network. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.